WSO2 Micro Integrator, also known as the MI, is a popular integration solution used in enterprise integration. You can implement mediation sequences, message transformation, enforcing security policies, and many other things using MI. In this video, we will focus on 6 different facts how to securely deploy it in your deployment. Number 1. Create a new keystore. The WSO2 MI or Micro Integrator comes with a default keystore. So this is used in many security features. So it includes SSL, mutual SSL, password encryptions, and so on. However, this default keystore is accessible to other users as well. You should generate a new keystore and trustor for the MI to make sure that your private certificate details are not exposed to anyone outside. You can use WSO2 key tool to generate keystores and trustors as you need. Otherwise, hackers can use these certificates to access your secure services. Number 2. Avoid using default H2 database and use the proper one. By default, WSO2 MI ship with the H2 embedded database for many different purposes. It includes cluster coordination, managing user stores, transaction counters, and so on. So it is not considered a good practice to use the H2 database in a deployment environment. H2 database is stored within the deployment environment so that people who have access to the deployment would also get access to this database file. Instead of having H2 database, you can use an open source commercially available databases. So WSO2 provide list of database where you can easily configure it with an MI. So it include MySQL, MSSQL, Oracle, Postgre, and IBM DB. So these databases are enterprise databases that provide much more security than a simple H2 database. It is essential to configure one of these databases for the heightened security rather than using a default H2 database. Number 3. Use a secure vault to store sensitive data. WSO2 MI use a Synapse-based XML document to specify and store mediation policies. In some cases, you might need to access the secure services and endpoints with a secret inputs like passwords. Storing this password configuration inside the mediation flow might not be a good solution. MI store them inside the MI hosted instance. If an attacker gains access to the MI instance, the password would be also visible for them. So MI offer a secure vault to store these sensitive informations. Rather than keeping data as a plain text, you can keep it as an encrypted value. When MI need that value, it can easily decrypt it. You can configure the text you need to encrypt under the secret section of the deployment TOML file. As you can see, the value is provided as the text value and wrap it with the square brackets. The cipher tool can be used to encrypt this plain text. After using the cipher tool, the value in square bracket is now becoming an encrypted value. Now you can use the secret key in your mediation flow instead of a plain text. The WSO2 vault lookup function able to read the corresponding deployment TOML key and decrypt that value. So in the same way, you can use the HashiCorp secret, Docker secrets, Kubernetes secrets as your vault for MI. Number 4. Hide observable data with log masking. Logging is an essential requirement when you are developing a server-side application. Logging is the most fundamental observability principle that you can use to track errors and determine their root causes. But logging sensitive information might have a negative impact on your security, so you must take precaution if you need to log credit card details and passwords. WSO2 MI let you mask these sensitive informations while it is logging. So WSO2 MI employs Log4j as its login library. So with Log4j, you can specify which log should be printed and where it should be printed. You can easily configure Log4j configuration in MI to filter out these informations. Number 5. Secure your proxy service in MI. MI's primary goal is to expose its mediation endpoint to the client endpoint. You need a proper security mechanism to authorize your services when you need to expose MI services to the outside. This made possible by web service security, also known as WS security. This implement various authentication and authorization policies on the MI endpoints. You can use MI to authenticate and authorize a client before it hitting a mediation flow. MI is offered numerous options such as username token, non-repudiation, integrity, confidentiality, and so on. As an example, you can set up your proxy service using a username token so that request with the username and password authenticate against an MI user store. With the MI CLI tool, you can create users and roles in MI user store. Number 6. Secure your REST APIs in MI. Now you know how to secure a proxy service using WSO2 MI. But what about APIs? Configuring API security is slightly different from the securing proxy service. MI offer two different methods for protecting APIs. So the first method is to expose your services using WSO2 API Manager Gateway. You can easily set up WSO2 API Manager Gateway to access the MI APIs. If you already have a proxy service that you need to expose, MI automatically add this artifact into the API Manager service catalog. With API Manager, you can define how you supposed to expose your MI APIs. Using API Manager, you can define authentications, authorizations, throttling, and many other policies that you need to apply before accessing the MI instance. The second approach is best for the programmers. To secure MI APIs, you can use Java code and MI handlers. The MI API handler is a Java hook that is activated before a request enters the API mediation flow and before the response is sent. To handle a request and response, it offers two different methods: handle request, handle response. These two functions return a Boolean value that indicate whether the request or response should proceed or not. You should restrict the API by implementing authorization logic on the handle request method with the matching return type. If it returns true, the request goes to the MI, or otherwise, it won't. Yes, there are a lot of things that we need to think about when we are performing a deployment. Here we have discussed only few of them. Think about other security requirements such as SSL, mutual SSL, DDoS prevention, so those things. Always keep in mind that the security is the number one priority.